Hello there, my music lovers. I'm Joshua the File Heaven, and today we're having a look at the Rebel amp from Rebel Audio. This is a $500 headphone amplifier, which also has a pre-function. The Rebel amp doesn't have many reviews yet, but I have a feeling that after seeing my review, a lot of other reviewers will just want to dig into it because it is so amazing. The unboxing is actually pretty simple. There is just the amplifier and the very thin instruction set inside. There is nothing else. It comes packaged like this. And this is the owner manual. There is nothing much in there. You have some on the back too, and that is pretty much it. And the amplifier looks like this. I have no idea why they went for green. It is an unusual color for an audio product, but it is green, as you can see. When it comes to the price, it costs $500. It is a mid-range price point for headphone amplifiers. The one thing it could do to stand out in this price range is drive very hard to drive headphones like Hifiman Hash A6 SA, Hifiman Aria, Kennerton Tror, Rosson Air AD Zero, and Crosszone CZ1. And to my satisfaction and to my joy, because I'm reviewing it and I have to tell you something, is that it can drive all of them. It has such a large headroom. It has a lot of power to drive headphones. It has no remote though. And at the front you have a gain setting, which you can set between medium at the bottom, low in the center, and high at the top. I always leave it to high, although I would want to tell you this, for Hifiman Sundara, it is enough to set it on the low to have some volume headroom adjustment. You have a pre, which you can set to either 0 or 1. Setting it to 0 enables the headphone output, while setting it to 1 actually disables the headphone output and makes it a pre-amplifier. As a pre-amplifier, it is supposed to offer you volume control if you are using a DAC which doesn't have it, between your speakers and their amplifier. As you can see, they made quite a few of those because the serial number is 274. So this is not the first unit they have made. They actually are selling those quite well. And a lot of people have said that they kind of look like they ripped the design from Sheet Audio. I do feel that there is some resemblance, but at the same time, when it comes to the audio, there is none. It beats the Sheet Audio quite hard when it comes to their similarly priced offers, because I have heard those. I didn't have the chance to review them because some friends do have Sheet Audio products, but I promise to you, I will do my best to review Sheet Audio products too in the near future. At the back, you have the input and the output, which is in a single-ended RCA format. You have the power input, you have a fuse in the power input, which is pretty cool because, let's say, a storm is raging outside, it is not going to burn your Rebel amplifier. And you have an on-off switch, which is actually pretty small, and I had to kind of feel for it because it was so tiny. On the other hand, at the front, you have an LED to show you that it is working. You have the headphone output, which is in the 6.3 millimeter format, and you have a volume wheel. When it comes to driving EMs or in-ear monitors, the Rebel amp actually has more than enough power to do so, but at the same time it has a bit of hiss. So especially if you have very sensitive EMs like the Campfire Atlas, I would recommend considering to get a slightly lower powered but more dedicated to EMs amplifier, like let's say the Earman Trump or EVX-DXD, both of which are actually less expensive than the Rebel amp. The Rebel amp is actually great for hard to drive headphones. Let's say you have Hifiman Aria and you can't quite get them as loud as you would like them to be. Well, the Rebel amp will be there to help you. The Rebel amp has so much driving power. I'm in love with it. I'm in love having so much headroom and so much dynamic. When it comes to the sound of it, it is dynamic, it is explosive, it is impactful, and it actually can be quite gentle in the mid-range, which was surprising because I have tested it straight up against the Lotopo 6000, which I simply had on my desk. So I used the Lotopo 6000 as a line-out device, so as a DAC to the Rebel amp, and then I connected the headphone to the headphone output of the Lotopo 6000. The headphone of choice has been Hifiman 2020i. This is a pretty hard to drive headphone. It is pretty much a Sundara or a Deva, which with less features, or at least it is a combination between Sundara and Deva. I promise to you there will be a review on this very soon too, because I'm in love with them. They have the advantages of both Sundara and Deva. The only thing that stands between you getting a Rebel amplifier and having this green beauty on your desk and you not getting it is the competition, because there is a fierce competition in the $500 price range, and you can actually get a Felix Echo for that money. The Felix Echo being a bit more interesting because it has tubes, but it is also single-ended. So when you compare the two, I would say that you will be getting the Felix Echo if you have only dynamic headphones. The Felix Echo actually prefers you having higher impedance headphones, which are easier to drive, than having planar magnetic headphones. With planar magnetic, I could hear much better control and much less distortion at very loud volumes with the Rebel Amp. The Rebel Amp is better for driving both dynamic and planar magnetic headphones. If you want to drive just dynamic headphones, you could get the Felix Echo because it has a slightly juicier mid-range, and if you do not need the headroom of the Rebel Amp, then you probably won't be using that headroom. On the other hand, neither of them can really drive VMs that well. Both of them are pretty much made for hard to drive larger headphones. Neither isn't really ideal for EMs. Another very competent competitor is the A90 from Toping. Zi, baby.
Ia-te, bebuțu.
Zi.
Zi. Vrei bebuțu iubire? Vrei iubire?
Puți, puți, puți.
I'm so lonely.
Hai, baby. Another very capable competitor for the Rebel Amp is the Toping A19 and the Toping D90. Both of them are pretty interesting devices actually, and the Rebel amplifier should give you something more than those two can. And that more is the headroom. The headroom of the Rebel Amp is huge. You have so much power that you will probably never run out of the power with this one. If you are purchasing a $500 amplifier, you probably won't have a headphone that is not drivable by it. If you have a headphone that is harder to drive than even it can drive, there is actually one more step, and that is the Audio GD Master 19. The Audio GD Master 19 has even more driving power, and that surprised me. That actually made me woohoo. I just realized that there is so much beauty in this world and there are so many options, but what would make you go for the Rebel amplifier rather than the competitors? Well, the color. Let's just be honest. You like this green, don't you? Well, if you don't like this green, then do not get it, because it is green. I don't know if they have other options. I haven't quite seen them. It is green. It has this beautiful overall case. It doesn't really get very hot during usage, but I would not really expect it to. It doesn't have any weird issues. For example, there were amplifiers that actually had an issue where they had cable microphonics. I have no idea how that was even possible. But if you touched the cables that went into the amplifier while listening to them, you would hear microphonics. Well, I can guarantee to you that the Rebel Amp doesn't have that. And it is surprising to know that anything at some point had it. The main disadvantages of getting the Rebel Amp are that it does not have balanced connectors. It doesn't have XLR outputs, it doesn't have an XLR output at the front for the pre, it just doesn't have balanced, and that may be a bit of an issue, but when was the last time when you used balanced outputs? I honestly do have balanced cables, but for the sake of being able to compare things, for the sake of being fair to everything, I tend to use single-ended more often than I use balanced connectors. For devices such as the Rebel Amp, but even for EMs, most of my EMs still come with a 3.5 mm single-ended cable. This means that it is way easier for me to know how everything compares if I keep everything single-ended. So until balanced becomes the new standard, until everything becomes balanced, I would actually think that you would use single-ended more often. For using balanced, you need to also have balanced cables. So even purchasing a balanced amplifier or a balanced pre-output, you need to invest in cables too. And the whole price goes a bit higher than the $500 price point of the Rebel Amp. At the end of the day, we are talking about an amplifier that can drive pretty much everything. It can drive EMs that are not sensitive to hiss, it can drive headphones, it can drive hard to drive headphones, it can drive Audesi LCD 2C, Audesi LCD MX4, it can drive Hi-Fi Man Sundara, it can drive Hi-Fi Man Deva, it can drive all of them, it can drive everything. It is pretty cool looking. I do enjoy a bit of color in my setup, as you can see, I do have a bit of more color now. And I do like it. I do like the Rebel amplifier, I do like Rebel Amp and Rebel Audio, and I am hoping that they will be releasing more specialized versions of it, like let's say an EM amplifier or something that is a bit more portable, because this is pretty huge, this is a desktop unit. And I'm hoping that they will be releasing a full-blown amplifier with both balanced outputs and a few more features, or even a DAX/Headphone amplifier and a DAX/ amp, or even speaker amplifier. So I am hoping that we will be seeing more awesome stuff from Rebel Audio in the future. I thank you for watching. You are the hero here because you are watching this channel. I hope you will also subscribe to this channel. Also, leave a like on this video if you enjoyed the content. It really helps me out. I hope you have a lovely week in there. And see each other soon.